parent whose kid is going over there, boy, do they feel it. Boy, do they feel it. And they just don't know which way to turn. They talk to the kid, they try to reason with the kid, but these kids are beyond reasoning. They need home sweet home.
They're just amazing here in Brooklyn. They really, they're good people here. They know how to take care of the troubled ones.
I think Home Sweet Home is a heroic example of how the most important part of a residence is pure love.
Home Sweet Home has become a place where, exactly as Avi dreamed, boys can go when they have nowhere else to go. And he's proven that with his method of disciplined love, where you can take a boy who everyone else has given up hope on and who hasn't been able to go home for many years and who's been what we call in She'el Tachtis, come back to the highest, I would say, to Igra Rama, to the highest level possible.
You take kids who are in an environment and you see they have certain issues and certain troubles, those troubles are rarely disconnected from the environment. There are always going to be certain factors in their environment that if it's not certainly the cause, then it's at least a contributing factor. You can take boys out of that environment. You can put them into an environment that's healthy, that's safe, that's somewhat supervised, but still gives them the independence that they need. It's spectacular what could happen. If you can motivate them, if you can speak to them, if you can take care of their daily needs, that they're not panicked as to how they're going to survive another day. If you can give them warmth, if you can give them love, if you can give them caring, if you give them unconditional caring, then what you have is an environment for growth which is literally unparalleled. I don't think there's any other institution, organization, home environment, there's nothing quite like Home Sweet Home for so many reasons. Both in terms of the content that they get, the program that they get, the professionals that they're exposed to, the amazing amount of care and love that they get here is just incredible. It's unparalleled. There really is nothing like it. So my involvement is a no-brainer. I'm involved in helping at-risk youth, and there's no place that helps them more than Home Sweet Home.
Baruch Hashem, there's a lot of love out there, and I feel that's the reason why they're succeeding with the program, why they have a lot of atzlocha. Even though, as of today, I have my family back and I don't need it that much, but I'm still going there and I still need it. And thank you, Avi, for everything that you did for me. Thank you, Miriam, for everything that you did for us and all the volunteers.
There is a no questions asked love for every kid that walks in there, no matter who he is, no matter what his issues are. Avi and all the rest of the volunteers and everyone involved is always there for you, even afterwards. Now I speak to Avi twice a week now, and I haven't been in Home Sweet Home for 2.5 years at least, and I'm still close with Avi, and I still ask him for advice. He's still there for me. He's there for everybody who's been through Home Sweet Home, and probably even people who haven't been through Home Sweet Home. He's there to help everybody. And it's the no questions love and care for every single person that goes through Home Sweet Home.
Actually, Home Sweet Home has done what a lot of government programs can't do. And that is, there are no strings attached to what you do. There are no strings attached to the love you give the boys. There are no strings attached to the gifts you give the boys. Stuff that you can't do in a government program.
At first, life in Home Sweet Home was a little bit tough, a little bit too much structure, and definitely a lot more structure than I had before that. And it was a little bit uncomfortable for me. But as I moved on, I realized that the structure wasn't people telling me what to do. It was me making the decision to do what I wanted to do based on other people's suggestions.
Just spend time with them, discussing anything and everything. Just show them that they're important. When they see that, they begin to flower and to come out, and they realize that there's more to life.
When I came into the program and I saw the difference between a regular program and this program, my feelings about everything totally changed. It taught me actually how to use each and every problem, how not to run away from the problem, just to solve it and be there and slowly, slowly just go through until it gets healed all the way. And just, in Baruch Hashem today, I'm taking care of my problems. I'm not going to sleep at night upset. I'm just happy when I'm going to sleep, and I'm looking forward for the next day. Right now, I love being alive, and I love myself, and everybody around me loves me.
There's no chosher avayda. There's no greater thing that a person can do. There's no greater reward that you have than working with Yiddish kinder and bringing them back to their chachayim and bringing them light into their lives.
Let me tell a tale, I beg you all to listen. I think you'll recognize that every word is true. It's the story that I tell about my brother, the brother that I loved but hardly knew. We were forced to live so far from one another, but it was more than distance keeping him from me. While I had the right to lead the life I'd chosen, all he yearned for was the day that he'd be free. How I dream that one day we could be together, doing all the things that brothers do. But I feared that I would have to dream forever, for only dreamers still believe that dreams come true. To gain his freedom and challenge those who dare.
Hi, my name is Yehuda Dubelsky. I come out every Monday night, or almost every Monday night, to spend some time with the boys from Home Sweet Home. We try to do a variety of different activities. Tonight we're here at Hitters and Hoops with a full court basketball game. And it's really a great experience. I've learned a lot from it, and hope to be able to continue.
And I worried what they must have done to me. Though the flame that made us brothers was still burning.
Monday night is the most favorite and exciting night of the week. We have a lot of fun playing Monday night. The guys are amazing, awesome. They give us more inspiration than they can imagine. You might think that we give them inspiration, but at the end of the day, they make us stronger and better people.
Hi, my name is Yanky Bash. I'm part of the Monday Night Volunteers. Me, Matis Friedman, Yitzi Cohn, Svi Oshitzer, and who always tries to come, Mati Zulberg. That we played a great game of basketball. I'm wiped out. I'm just glad a great time. I'm just glad all the parts are where I left them. And it was a great bunch of kids, and had a great time.
This is my first week. I want to say it's a very good place, very caring people, and I'm enjoying it so much. It's a very good place.
But he who rules the world heard our prayers. How I wept the day they set my brother free.
My name is Leiby Schwimmer. I'm a Wednesday night volunteer in Home Sweet Home program. Usually I come to the house at about 8:30 in the evening. Gather the boys up and we take them to a gym, and we play racquetball, we work out, and we have a good time together. And usually we go afterwards to Dav Marv, and then we go home afterwards and say goodnight to each other.
Hi, my name is Moshe Solomon. I volunteer Wednesday night with Home Sweet Home. Going to Home Sweet Home is a great feeling. You really feel like you're doing something. You see the outcome. We see how the kids came in, great kids, but you see how they developed over time, literally week to week.
Well, Home Sweet Home, I don't know how to explain how they do it, but they just do it because they don't put pressure on you.
they let you go, but they know when to come and catch you. They know when the right moment is to talk to you about whatever it is that you need help in. They don't wait too long, and they don't jump in too quick.
The main reasons why Home Sweet Home is successful is that they let the boys grow on their own pace. They don't push the boys. They give them a tremendous amount of love and care and attention, and they're able to grow step by step when they're ready.
Hi, my name is Yanky Kaczynski. I am the Motzei Shabbos volunteer. And we go out. We come back 2, 3, and I'm not sure if I'm supposed to say this on the camera, sometimes 4. But we have a very good time. And I think the guys enjoy it. And I definitely enjoy it, that's for sure. Give a lot of credit to everybody that's able to pick themselves up and come out here, because I think we're all in this for the same reason. We all do this because of our heart and soul. And we do this because we really, really care. And after a while, the boys really become part of our lives.
Success and continued success of Home Sweet Home is anybody that joins the Home Sweet Home and everybody that has had an opportunity to participate in any capacity just feels like they have to continue. It's not any kind of a burden. It's not something that, oh, I have to have them for Shabbos, or I have to go out there and be together with them tonight. I want to. I really, really want to. And this is the success that Home Sweet Home has had and that Home Sweet Home will, Be'ez Hashem, continue to have. In the beginning, some of them come, they're angry, not particularly at us, but maybe just at the world, and withdrawn, and after not even such a long time, you start to notice they start to smile and open up more. Their mental health and well-being, there's a great change in that. As far as the religious changes, it's also an amazing thing. That's one of the great things about Home Sweet Home, is that they don't twist their arms to make them become religious. And we see on their own, the boys, when they first come to our house, they're just sleeping mostly. And then they come to Mincha, or they come to Ma'ariv, and then they come to Shacharis, and then some of them are in Yeshiva full-time now. So it's an incredible, incredible change. I think the piece you get to Home Sweet Home is that the boys come in on their own. They come in to Home Sweet Home on their own. The choices that they make, for the most part, are on their own. I'm not even sure what it is that they start to come back to Yiddishkeit and start to come back to being clean and leading normal, productive lives. I think that they realized that they had their fun, they did their damage, and now it's time to become a productive person in society. And